chapter 2, all these topics. In this video, we will cover all these practicals. So, let's start.
Creating tables. Microsoft Word 2010 offers many different ways to create table in our document. So first, let's start with the simplest method to create a table. Just right-click from the mouse and come to the new option for creating a new Microsoft Word document. So first here you have to write any title for this Word document, as I am writing a practice Word. Now we are going to open it for creating a table. Word is the very simplest application software in which we can do documentation. We can edit our data, we can save it, we can insert picture and any other graphics. Even we can do some easiest calculation as well. So you can see this is our blank Word document. And first we will learn creating table using a table button. So this is the easiest way to create table in Word document. We will go here at the Insert tab, and you can find under the Insert tab there is a table option, and click over the table option and you can find all the grids. These are the grids. Whenever you will put this mouse cursor over the grid, automatically you will see these grids, number of grids are present in your sheet. So according to your choice, how many rows and how many columns are required, you can select the rows and column according to your choice. So I want 7 rows and 2 columns. I'm going to select it. Now this way you can add table in your Word document. Now let's study the second one, how we can insert table using a insert table option. Again we have to go here insert tab, and from here you can select the table option again, and after crossing the grids you can find the second option, that is insert table. Just click to the insert table, one more dialog box will appear on your screen, and here this dialog box is asking how many columns and how many rows are required to create a table. So I want 5 columns and 2 rows. Okay, now press OK. So this way you can create rows and column in your table. Now the second way to create table is, another way to create a table is by drawing it manually in a Word document. Now for drawing it manually, what we have to do, again with the same option, we have to land on the dialog box which is just given after the insert table. Given option is draw table. Press here on the draw table option, and when you will put your mouse cursor on a blank document, your mouse cursor will convert into a pencil, and with the help of pencil you can draw a rectangle, right? So this rectangle will help you to create rows and columns according to your choice. How many rows and how many columns are required, you can draw with the pencil which is appearing on your blank document. this is the way you can draw a table in your MS Word document. Now I'm quickly entering one table from here. Then I'll show you how we can add value. Now second is entering value in the table. After creating your table, you can enter value in the table cell. So what is cell here? When we are making a table, when we are creating a table, you can see one horizontal line and one vertical line is crossing each other, and they are creating a small rectangular box. This rectangular box is called cell. So you can find out how many cells are here. This is one cell, this is two, this is 3, 4, 5, and 6. So there are total 6 cells in a row, and you, same way you can come across to the second row, and you can find 1, 2, 3, 4, total 6, 12, 18, and so on. Alright, so this way, this is called a cell. Now the next is how we can enter a value. So this right now I show you how we can enter the value. Just we have to keep the mouse cursor under a cell, and you can type your data according to your choice. If you want to type a digit, that is also valid, and if you want to type any word or any name, any data, you can also type that also. Like I'm writing here, sun, moon, flower. Okay, just you have to put the mouse cursor in that cell and you can easily type your data. Next is inserting row or column in the cell. So inserting row and column, what we have to do, sometimes to expand the table we need more columns or row in it. In our table we need some more row or column. So how we can insert that? What gives you the facility to add new row or column in the existing table at any position? At any position you can add one new row, one new column, and more than one row and column. So to inserting a row or column, we will do this way. You can click any on the column cell where you want to insert a new row or column. Like I want to insert in the second one. Now click on the layout tab under the table tool. This is the layout tab, and under the table you can find rows and column. Now here in the row and column tab, already 4 options are given, that is insert above, insert below, insert left, and insert right. So these options are very helpful for inserting any row and column in your table. Like I want to insert one row under the selected row, so clicking here, now you can find the black one. This is the inserted row which I have inserted from layout tab. So this way you can add number of rows and number of columns in your table. Next is selecting cell in a table. Now, how you gonna select cell if you want to write something or if you want to do any editing in your table? So selecting a cell, you can select multiple cell, rows and column in a table to collectively edit or format the data stored in these. So how can you select a single cell? If you are working in a table and you want to edit in single cell, or if you want to write something, so how can you select a single cell from a table? So for selecting a single cell, we can just put the mouse cursor in our desired place. If you want to write it the first cell, just put the mouse cursor and double click here, and you are allowed to type the data which you want to write here. Okay, so this way we can write anything, we can select a single cell as well. Now how to select all cells in a row? So for selecting us all the cell in a row, how can you do that? You have to put the mouse cursor and press the right mouse, and now you can see this black shaded portion is totally selected for doing any formatting or editing. Now the next part is, how can you select any particular row or column? Okay, so for selecting a row or column, you have to click at the top of that row or side of that column, beginning of that column. Okay, suppose I want to select this one, I have to keep the cursor at the top of the row and select it. Okay, so this way you can select any row, any single row and any single column. Now there is one more alternate way to select your row, column and table. For doing so, we have to click anywhere in our table and you will find at the top layout option where I am keeping my mouse cursor, and after keeping your mouse cursor on the table, you will find layout option. Again, you can find at the top ribbon layout option is given. Select the delete option in the row and column group. So row and column group, it is given at the third one. You can find here delete option. Just click here on the delete. Now again four options are asking that delete cell, delete column, or delete a row, or a delete table. So I just want to delete a column. I want to delete a column. Okay, the selected row is deleted now. Now what if I want to just delete a single cell? Again we have to select that individual cell which we want to delete. Come to the layout option, come to delete tab and click on delete cell. Okay, so this way you can delete it. Now you can check here that one cell is already deleted, that is why from here that last line of border is missing. Okay, now come to the resizing row or column. When you insert a new table in a Word document, you get all the columns of equal width and all the rows of equal height. But sometime to adjust the data in a cell, you need to change their width or height. For to change a width or a column, what we can do, position a mouse cursor at the right edge of the column. Now here you can see this kind of tool you will get when you will place your mouse cursor at the end of the row and column. When you will place at the row, you can find this one, and when you are going to place your mouse cursor at the end of the column, types of table style is given. This will help Selecting cell from here and coming to the layout option, and layout option you can find here formula option given on the data tab at the last one. So this formula option will add a formula to cell to perform a simple calculation such as average, sum or count. Now clicking on formula tab, and you can find sum left. That means you have to do a sum of all the data in a row wise. If you want to do a column, you can do a right here. You can add it and you can type the right after the sum. Now it is already written here. I'm clicking OK. Now you can find we have summed up all mathematics, science and English marks of the only one student, and this way you can perform with the second student also. Just click here on the second one and put to the cursor again, right click on the sum and find the second answer. So this way you can calculate the sum with the formula option in a row wise also and in a column wise also. Now next is rearranging data in a table. So this is the most important part in this chapter. Data stored in a table can be rearranged in ascending or descending order. Ascending means from small to big, and descending means from big to small. The process of rearranging the data record is called data sorting. The process when you rearrange data in your table, that is known as data sorting. So for sorting your data, what you have to do, select the column with reference to whom the data has to be sorted. Like I want to sort my marks in mathematics from decreasing one, like smallest will come at the top and biggest digit or biggest number will come at the bottom. So for doing sorting, what we have to do, you have to click on the layout tab again, and here you will find the data sort option under the data where I am keeping my cursor. So click here on the maths number, and here you can find sort by 20, yes, but the text should be changed into a number and using a paragraph ascending. Okay, so it will be descending, and then press, you have to select the same thing at here also. Invalid data. Let's do again once from ascending. Okay, but the text should be changed into the number. And option column 4. for doing a change, we have to select all rows and column. For selecting rows and column, clicking here at the corner, coming to the layout option. If you want to do ascending, that means from small, big to small, you have to click here and press OK. Now you can see the mathematic marks is 15, 20 and 20. Now if you want to do a descending, then press descending and click OK. Now you can see mathematic marks is 20, 20 and 15. So this way you can do a sorting in your data.